السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله، عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وقال تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما، والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما، والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما، إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما. صدق الله العظيم. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher and protector. May the choicest of his blessings and salutations be upon our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, first and foremost, it is incumbent upon all of us that we thank Allah the Almighty for all of the numerous bounties that He has bestowed upon us, all the numerous favors that He has conferred upon us. For if we were to try to count these favors, we would fail miserably. All the things that we see around us, within ourselves, within our bodies, every single thing, whether it be positive or negative, is a favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where we are indebted that we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in utmost gratitude. But even if we were to spend our whole lives in sajda, in prostration, that would not suffice as gratitude for the numerous blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. But nevertheless, we being humble slaves of Allah the Almighty, we do our level best in offering our thanks and our gratitude to our beloved Maker. Likewise, it is also from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has not made all of the days equal. All of the days equal, or all of the places equal. For example, if we were to take in regard to days, Friday has a special virtue attached to it in regard to its levels of spirituality. Likewise, the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. And then the month of Ramadan, in comparison to all months, the month of Ramadan has a special virtue. And in regard to places, for example, where we are seated now, this is one of the houses of Allah the Almighty. But if we were to compare it with Makkah al-Mukarramah, Makkah al-Mukarramah is indeed a better, more blessed and more sacred place than the place that we are seated in. But if we were to compare this very house of Allah that we are seated in with our own houses, this house of Allah the Almighty is much more blessed, much more sacred than our own homes, our own houses. So just imagine, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, now if you were to be found in a friend's house all the time, what would people come up with? They would draw a conclusion that you are indeed a very close friend of that person. For you would not spend your time, or you would not just barge into anyone's house. If you are a very close friend of his, yes, you would spend some time with him. So just imagine the person, the slave of Allah, who spends his time in the house of Allah. The more time he spends, the more a person can, when he looks at him, you can draw a conclusion that indeed he is one of the friends of Allah the Almighty. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from his awliya. And likewise, the hadith of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the seven special VIPs, the seven special VIPs who would get a shade, who will be under the shade on the day where there will be no other shade other than the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of those people, one of those seven persons is the person who قلبه معلق بالمساجد. His heart is connected to the masajid, to the houses of Allah the Almighty. His heart is attached to the masajid of Allah the Almighty. He finishes one salah and he is waiting for another salah. He finishes his asr salah and now he is planning on how he is going to wear or which masjid is he going to catch for salatul maghrib and then salatul isha. His whole 24 hours, his whole day evolves around the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, around his prayers. He is a person, his heart is connected to the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So likewise, there are so many blessings and favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all around us, which at times we are oblivious of these favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah the Almighty not make us oblivious of such favors and blessings that are right in front of our eyes. Instead, we try to think out of the box or think far, whilst we have so many favors within our own selves, just around us. So let's look at them and not, you know, think of them as insignificant, but rather they are great blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when talking about thinking out of the box, there's a story. You know, Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson, right? Once they went on a camping trip together. Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson. They went on a camping trip. Now this is just a story to highlight the fact that we should not remain oblivious of what's in front of us. So both of them, they went on a camping trip and they pitched their tent now and it's night. So Sherlock Holmes, he asked Dr. Watson, Watson, what do you see in the sky? So Watson says, I see so many stars, perhaps a million stars. So Sherlock Holmes, now both of them are detectives as we all know. So he asks Dr. Watson, so Watson, what do you deduce from this sight? So Dr. Watson, he says, well, as there are a million stars, naturally from those million stars, they're celestial beings, celestial objects, there has to be so many planets. And from those planets, there's bound to be a share of planets which must be like planet Earth. So if there are planets, and see the detectives, so they're going on and on, they're ranting. So if there are planets like planet Earth, then there is bound to be life on these planets. So if there is life on these planets, then there are bound to be human beings like us in those planets. So Sherlock Holmes, he says, Watson, you idiot, you know what it means? Somebody has stolen our tent. You don't have to go as far as the heavens and celestial objects to deduce the fact that the tent is gone. You're inside a tent and he looks up at the heavens and he's seeing the stars. So naturally the tent has been stolen. So likewise, we should not remain oblivious of the facts that are in front of us. The blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are right in front of us. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given us an opportunity where we get to continue on to the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His glorious names and attributes. And in the last session we discussed about Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim. So today inshaAllah ta'ala we're going to discuss a very powerful ayah indeed. An ayah which describes some special people, and they are the Ibadur Rahman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses these special slaves of His as Ibadur Rahman. Now there is a slight difference between Ibad and Abid, which is known to the scholars of the Arabic language. Abid is more general. When you say Abid, you mean all of the slaves of Allah. And Ibad are special slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah the Almighty, instead of attaching the name Ibad to Ibadullah, or Ibad of any other name of His, He says Ibadur Rahman. Ibadur Rahman. So Rahman, as we discussed in the previous session, is one of the famous names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and indeed a powerful name of Allah the Almighty, and a name which is specific and special to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which denotes His utmost mercy, His compassion. His compassion, Ar-Rahman, the most merciful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says Ibadur Rahman, to highlight the very fact that they are special slaves of Allah, And these special slaves of Allah are going to get the complete blanket mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who are these Ibadur Rahman? Now the ayah that I recited in the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to describe these Ibadur Rahman. So we, being the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we go through these qualities, we should try to implement them in our lives so that we also can be categorized amongst the Ibadur Rahman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the Ibadur Rahman. So the first ayah that I recited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَانِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا. They are those, the Ibadur Rahman, they are those who walk on the face of this earth, هَوْنًا, with ease, humbly, slowly. They are the Ibadur Rahman. Not harshly, when I say slow, I'm not meaning slow as a tortoise, but slowly, softly. They don't walk arrogantly or out of pride. وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. And the slaves of Allah the Almighty, Ibadur Rahman, إِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ. If the ignorant, if the ones who have no knowledge, if they confront them, if they try to argue with them, or if they speak harsh words, they say salama. They say peace be unto you and they move on. They don't involve themselves in futile arguments. They don't waste their time arguing with the ones who are ignorant. They rather they say salam and they move off in peace. Allah goes on to describe them. وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. And they are those. Now the category number one is that you walk softly, quietly on the face of this earth. Likewise, you do not confront the ignorant, the people who are ignorant. You don't argue with them. Rather, you speak words of peace and move on. You control your temper, in other words. The second quality, وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. They spend a part of their night, a portion of their night, sujjadan wa qiyama, either in sajda or either in qiyam. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to highlight here is that they spend part or a portion of their night in prayer. They wake up for qiyamul layl, for tahajjud. They spend a portion of their night in prayer. So this, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, has been emphasized a lot in many ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but sadly it has become something very difficult for all of us in general, including myself, that you know, to spend some time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself addresses our beloved Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, Ya ayyuhal muzzammil, kumin layla illa qaleela, nisfahu awinqus minhu qaleela. And the ayat go on, oh, the one who is wrapped in garments, get up in the قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Wake up in the night except for you can spend a portion of it for your sleep, but other than that, try to spend most of your time in salah. So many ahadith discussing the virtue of tahajjud. This is the time when your respected elders and brothers in Islam, our beloved maker comes to the lowest heaven. Allah the Almighty, He Himself comes to the lowest heaven and calls out, which of my slaves, who is awake, seeking my forgiveness so that I can forgive him. So, should we not consider ourselves lucky if we are up at that time whilst the whole world is asleep and we raise our hands, Ya Allah, forgive my sins, and Allah the Almighty is there, right there, waiting to forgive you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to say, which of my slaves, who is there to ask of me so that I may give from my treasures, I may give from my khazana. So, should we not consider ourselves lucky if we are at that time seeking Allah's bounty, Allah's grace, Allah's virtues at that time? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us to wake up at night and spend our nights in worship. There are many ahadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, many ahadith. One is that, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hadith goes along the lines of these words, that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon the one, the man who wakes up, he wakes up for prayer. And whilst he wakes up for prayer, his wife is sleeping, he wakes her up too. And if she refuses, he sprinkles water on her. He sprinkles water on her to wake her up. And likewise, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on the woman, on the lady, the believing slave of Allah. Even she wakes up for salah in the middle of the night and her husband is asleep, she sprinkles water on him to wake him up. Now don't go and pour buckets of water, just sprinkle. Sprinkle water to wake them. You might hear something else if we pour buckets of water. So we sprinkle water. In this way, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, for the ones who are married, if you can do this. This is a great sunnah of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And likewise, there are many virtues attached to the ones who wake up for tahajjud, spend their night in salah. So this is the second category. The third one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to describe ibadur rahman, وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ, and they are those who continuously seek from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رَبَّ نَصْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ. They keep on praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, turn away, إِصْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ. The punishment of the Jahannam, take it away from us, turn it away from us. Inna عَذَابَهَا كَانَ غَرَامًا. Indeed, the punishment of Jahannam, it is ever adhering. غَرَامًا, difficult to bear. إِنَّهَا سَاءَتْ مُسْتَقَرًّا وَمُقَامًا. Indeed, Jahannam is a place that it is such an evil place that it is not a place to even abide therein temporarily or even for eternity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. The ibadur rahman, they continuously seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection from Jahannam. Likewise, the next quality, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَنْفَقُوا لَمْ يُسْرِفُوا وَلَمْ يَقْتُرُوا وَكَانَ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ قَوَامًا. And they are those, when they spend, they don't spend extravagantly. They don't spend extravagantly. They don't splurge. Rather, nor are they stingy. But they are moderate. They are not extravagant, nor are they stingy, but rather they take a middle stance in their spending. And they do much charity. They are from the ibadur rahman. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to describe, وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرٍ. And they are those, لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ. They do not invoke or besiege any other ilah, any other god other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They only turn to Allah the Almighty. وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّذِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. Nor do they murder. وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّذِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. They do not commit murder. وَلَا يَزْنُونَ. Nor do they commit any form of zina. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ يَلْقَ أَثَامًا. As for the one who commits either of these sins, he will face the penalty for what he has committed. وَلَا يَزْنُونَ. They do not commit zina. And when you say zina, it doesn't necessarily mean the act of fornication or adultery. See, today, we're living in a time, we've heard that when the signs of Qiyamah, one of the signs of Qiyamah is that zina will take place in the open. Zina will take place in the open, and the one who goes and tells those people who are committing zina, please do it aside, they will be considered the ones who have iman at that time. So seriously, today when you take social media, you see people liking unwanted pages. You see people having relationships openly on Facebook. Say two friends, a boy and a girl, he says, I'm with so and so, I'm missing so and so. He's texting this, and you know what? He's doing this, he's putting up his statuses to show it to the world, to show his love to the world, to show how he behaves, how this indecent behavior with this girl, he's showing it to the world. So the people of Iman, what would they do? They would call this person up, or perhaps text him, or chat with him and tell him, brother, what you're doing is wrong. It is haram. And you're doing an even greater sin by publicizing it. You're doing an even greater sin by bringing it out in the open. You have 1,000 friends, you're publicizing it to all of your 1,000 friends that, look, I'm having a relationship. A haram relationship with a girl from this country or that country. And every single, I go out with her, I sit with her, I talk to her, I do this, I do that. Every single thing is uploaded. Pictures are uploaded. Zina is happening in the open. So the one who calls him up and tells him, please brother, do it privately, it's haram. But then don't do it on Facebook, don't publicize it. It is an act of Iman. We are living in a time close to the day of Qiyamah. It is a sign from the signs of the day of Qiyamah. So they are those who would not commit zina in any of its forms. يُضَعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَيَخْلُدُ فِيهِ مُهَانًا. And for those who commit either one of these things, shirk, associating partners unto Allah, murder, zina, any of these sins, they will meet the penalty. And likewise, their punishment on the day of Qiyamah will be multiplied. يُضَعَفْ. It will be multiplied many fold on the day of Qiyamah. Allah save us all. وَيَخْلُدُ فِيهِ مُهَانًا. And they will abide in the Jahannam forever, disgraced and in humility. إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا. Now once again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our beloved maker, the one who is so compassionate. Look, the one who is so compassionate, he, as he mentions Ibadur Rahman, is talking about his mercy. Now he comes to all of these categories and he says, even if they commit these sins, illa man tab, except for those who, he was talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was mentioning that the punishment will be multiplied manyfold, except for those who make tawbah. إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ, and they bring in iman back again, they renew their iman. وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا, and they also do good deeds. فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. الله أكبر. Look at the mercy of our beloved maker. Allah says, as for the ones who make tawbah, renew their iman and do good deeds, for them, يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ, Allah the Almighty in His infinite mercy and kindness, He would change all of their evil deeds. Even if those deeds be like the froth of the sea. Even if it be like the froth of the sea, Allah the Almighty guarantees, He assures that He would change all of those evil deeds, حَسَنَاتِ, into good deeds. Into good deeds. See, that's the special thing. A person who comes into the fold of Islam, a person who comes into the fold of Islam, he says he comes in with a new slate. Yes, correct, he does come in with a new slate. But that doesn't mean his account is empty. No. The mercy of Allah is so vast and so encompassing that he, the minute he comes into the fold of Islam, he does not come in with a new slate that is blank. No. Number one, his evil deeds are changed into good deeds. He comes into the fold of Islam with an account already filling up. All of his evil deeds, say he committed so many murders, zina, you name it. All of those sins are converted into mountains of good deeds. You take the two scales, perhaps the evil scale was low and the good scale was high up, empty. He comes into the fold of Islam, he makes tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala converts the sins into good deeds. The good side becomes heavy. And likewise, all of those good deeds that he did even whilst he was a kafir, all of those good deeds are transferred. Say he did acts of charity, he was a philanthropist, he did so many acts of charity, he helped people, he did this, he did that. All of those good deeds are transferred. Are transferred. He comes into the fold not with an empty slate, but a new slate which is filled with good deeds. This is the infinite mercy of our beloved Creator, our beloved Maker, Allah the Almighty. So Allah says that for the one who makes tawbah, renews his iman, and he does good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala converts and changes all of his evil deeds into good deeds. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. And indeed Allah the Almighty is most forgiving. Most forgiving. We should never ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah, in the forgiveness of Allah. However great a sinner we may be, we may hate our own selves, we may be disgusted at our own selves, we may look at the mirror and see and think, you know, what a waste am I. You see, many a time sins look beautiful and rosy, but after the sin you feel disgusted. You feel disgusted. You feel, why did I go to this party? Or why did I behave in such a manner? Why? Maybe zina would look beautiful for you outside, but the minute you are done with zina, the minute you're done with zina, the minute you're done with that act, you don't even want to look at another woman. That's how Allah has created men. You don't even want to look at another woman for perhaps a day or two. And then you feel so much of remorse and so much of guilt that why did I involve myself in such a sin? But on the other hand, if you do good deeds, you do good deeds, you feel so light-hearted. You feel so happy. You're content for the whole day or perhaps the next day too. That Allah, I did a good deed for your sake. For your sake, Ya Allah. That is the barakah. That is the blessing of good deeds. And the other hand, that is the evil of vice and transgression. For the more you fall into the pits of sin, the more you feel hatred to yourself. But remember, even if you hate yourself, Allah the Almighty is waiting to forgive you. You only have, the only thing that you have to do is turn to Him in sincere tawbah. If you do, Allah the Almighty immediately forgives all of your sins. And this, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, is only until the sun rises from the west, as we all know. For when the sun rises from the west, the door of tawbah will be slammed shut. and afterwards, even if you stay your whole life in sajda, you cry tears of blood, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to forgive your sins. And like I said, we are living in a time very close to the day of Qiyamah, very close. The major signs are all that is remaining. So don't delay, don't delay. You keep an intention firmly that you want to make tawbah, do it immediately. Don't wait for Ramadan and 27th night and 29th night and tawbah is only for Ramadan. No. Tawbah is not only for the sinners, tawbah is not only for Ramadan, tawbah is for every single Muslim. It has to be a part and parcel of his day-to-day life. For we are sinners, continuous sinners. We sin continuously. We are consecutive sinners. You go out, you sin. You at home, you sin. Morning, we sin. In the night we sin, we are continuous sinners. So we need to keep on seeking repentance. We need to keep on turning in repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking His forgiveness. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to describe another few qualities. Just another 2-3 ayat and then we'll wrap it up. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَشْهَدُونَ الزُّورِ. They are also those who do not bear false witness. You have not witnessed something with your own eyes. You have not seen it. Don't go around talking about it. You have not clarified information that has come to you. Don't go around passing it. لا يشهدون الزور. They don't bear false witness. وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِاللَّغْوِ مَرُّوا كِرَامًا. And if they pass by a group of people talking vain talk, useless talk, unwanted talk, they مَرُّوا كِرَامًا. They pass away dignified. They don't spend time there. They don't waste time there. They move away. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِّرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ. And they are also those when the ayat of Allah. And when we say ayat, it doesn't necessarily have to mean the Quran ayat. Rather the signs of Allah. It could be the Quran, the benefits, the favors, the mercy of Allah, whatever. You look around every single creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of these are signs. All of these are ayat. These ayat, when it is mentioned to these ibadur rahman, they are those لَمْ يَخِرُّ عَلَيْهَا سُمَّوْ وَعُمْيَانَا. They do not pass away from those signs acting as if they are deaf or blind. And in that, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, we, this handful of us, we are, and every single believer who takes part in any of these gatherings, likewise, they are considered from this group because they are listening to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you and me. We are listening to the words of Allah the Almighty and the words of His beloved Rasul, alayhi salatu wasalam. We do not turn a deaf ear or a blind eye. And they are also those يقولون, they say, رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَجَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. They are those who keep on praying to Ya Allah. They keep on praying to Allah, Ya Allah, رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا. O our Rabb, هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا. Give us from our wives, from our husbands, وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا, and from our children, قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ. Children and spouses who will cool our eyes. Qurrata a'yun. They will literally make us cry, but make us cry out of happiness, not out of sadness. Qurrata a'yun. Waj'alna lilmuttaqina imama. And Ya Allah, make us as a good example, as a role model for the people of taqwa. Allah says finally the closing ayah, Allah caps it off by saying, أُولَٰئِكَ يُجْزَوْنَ الْغُرْفَةَ بِمَا صَبَرُوا وَيُلَقَّوْنَ فِيهَا تَحِيَّةً وَسَلَامًا خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا حَسُنَتْ مُسْتَقَرًّا وَمُقَامًا. Finally Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they are those, their reward will be يُجْزَوْنَ الْغُرْفَةَ بِمَا صَبَرُوا. They will be given chambers. They will be given castles, palaces, rooms in Jannah بِمَا صَبَرُوا. For what they endured in this world. The trials, the calamities, the tests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For all that they bow patience, they endured patiently, this is their reward. وَيُلَقَّوْنَ فِيهَا تَحِيَّةً وَسَلَامًا. And on that day, they will be greeted, the malaika will greet them with greetings, congratulations, and salam and peace after peace. The angels will be in throngs waiting to greet them and welcome them into their palaces, into their castles, and into their chambers. خالدين فيها. They will remain and abide in those castles in Jannah, in paradise, for eternity, for eternity. حسنت مستقرا ومقاما. And indeed, حسنت مستقرة ومقامة. As we were discussing earlier about Jahannam, we said ساعت مستقرة ومقامة. Jahannam is a place evil. Evil, whether it be temporarily or forever. But on the other hand, Jannah حسنت مستقرة ومقامة. It is the most best of places for an individual to abide and live in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caps the ayah with this final verse by mentioning the reward that will be given to the Ibadur Rahman. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of our good deeds, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the Ibadur Rahman who will be covered with the blanket mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah the Almighty, just as how He has united us today in His house, may Allah the Almighty unite us in the gardens of Jannah. Wa akhir da'wa ya alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Jazakum.